All right, guys, so I'm gonna walk you through the story about the Pan fam, the Pan family. Pan fam for short. So luckily the neighbors across the street, they had a camera perched up above the garage, pointing straight at the Pan fam's house. And that camera caught three intruders walking up to the house that night. They enter the house, they start demanding money. So the mother's woken up to a barrel right in her face. And then the father is woken up and then he's brought downstairs. So Jennifer then tells the police that she was in her room upstairs on the phone when she hears something go down that was outside of the ordinary. She said that she could tell that those footsteps outside her bedroom weren't her parents. Like, okay, Jen. So Jennifer then peeks out of the door and she also finds the barrel in her face as well. So one intruder ties Jen's hands up with a shoelace and then drags her from room to room, destroying the place in search of money. She gives the intruder $2,500 that she saved up herself from teaching piano, and then $1,100 that her mother kept hidden. But again, that's not enough. So Han, the father, explains that he doesn't have any money on him. So the robbers get upset with hearing this because, like, uh-oh, how are we gonna get more cash now? And they probably think, like, this was probably a stupid idea. So they hit Han, Jen's dad, across the head, and then they take Jennifer upstairs. They tie her up to the banister, which arguably I would have taken her with me too, considering she just funded the burglars just $3,600. And then another intruder marches the parents to the basement and they make them face a wall and they put a blanket over their head. The mom pleads to spare her daughter's life. And then the intruder shoots 5 times. So this is where the story feels a little off to me. They completely spare Jennifer. Like, why break into this house, steal all that money, and then off her parents? Jennifer then calls 911. She tells the operator people that people just broke into her house and she just heard shots, like pop, 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 pop. So then 34 minutes into the call, guess who it is? It's Han, it's the father. He survived his own, like he survived. And he's running outside to seek help. He's screaming from waking up and discovers that his wife is at his feet. She's gone and she's no longer breathing. So police arrive to the house. They find Jennifer tied up upstairs. And this is what confuses the hell out of everyone. How is she tied up to the banister and making a 911 call? How could three guys that robbed and off two people leave a witness? These people had no problem taking these two people out. So why would they just leave one behind? There were even credit cards and money left on the counter after the intruders left. I mean, that sounds like the worst intruders ever. The police are like, wait a minute, hold up. How did Jennifer call 911 and then flip a phone while she's tied up to the banister? They called Jennifer in for questioning and they have her demonstrate how she got the phone out of her waistband while she was tied up. So she demos it and seems plausible that she could have made the call. So the police, they don't buy into her story. They have a undercover secret police follow Jen around, even to her own mother's funeral. And they notice, they watch Jen and she doesn't even seem sad. She's like not even crying. It's like there's no remorse. Like, I know if my own mom was gone, I'd be shedding tears. Bad news for Jennifer. Han comes out of his coma and tells the police every single detail that he remembers from that night. And guess what? Surprise, surprise. It's a completely different story than what Jennifer said. Han, the dad, had been such an overbearing parent, he like chose her career path. So Jennifer would start living this double life. She was forging her report cards when in actuality, she never even graduated high school. She faked an acceptance letter from the pharmacy school her dad wanted her to go to. And then she makes up stories about the professor. Jennifer just wants to keep her parents happy. Like, damn, I'm still trying to figure out how to get electronic signatures on documents. She's a good liar. Jennifer is living this fantasy just to escape her real life. And of course, her parents, I mean, they were insanely strict, and to top it all off, dating was forbidden. Excuse me. She had been living with her boyfriend in secret the whole time, and he was a drug dealer. Then they discover that Jen She didn't even have a BA in pharmacy. It was all a lie. So they then take her home and she's banned from many things. She's basically in prison. Like, if you thought that her life was super strict then, just imagine now. She's got nothing except for piano lessons. So her dad says, either go back to school and stop seeing your drug dealing boyfriend, or leave the house, or just wait until I'm dead. Her boyfriend puts her in contact with two guys that will off her parents for her that he knew through doing his drug dealing business. He texted her saying, I did everything and lined it up for you. You ain't gotta do anything. He had paid the intruders $10K to whack her parents. But Jennifer's plan was a bust because her dad survived that night. Like, how do you survive? And $10K to off somebody? I mean, you gotta pay taxes on that. He says that he saw his own daughter come downstairs unbound and talk with a guy in a friendly manner. Blood may be thick, but it's not that thick. And so her dad basically is like, my daughter's a liar. And I kept thinking, why would you just not move out? It's so much easier. Like, why go through all that trouble and off your parents? It was easier in her mind to off them because why continue to disappoint them? So they bring Jennifer back in for questioning because that is just super sus. They question her for 9 straight hours. Jennifer finally decides it's time to tell the truth. And the story just keeps on getting crazier. Jen tells the police that it was supposed to be her that was supposed to be offed. And she comes up with this full hoax lie that she was trying to commit suicide. But supposedly at the last minute, she had to change her heart and she called it off. But she didn't have the money to pay the 10 grand cancellation fee. So apparently these guys showed up and they just off her parents. Like, they question the boyfriend. They bring Daniel in for questioning and he tells the police that she definitely wanted her parents gone. He, Daniel, gave Jennifer a burner phone. So she got rid of the SIM card, but the police were able to find the phone and it hadn't even erased all the texts. The most telling text of all is right before her mother was taken out and her father supposedly was, that text read VIP access, which of course I assume means you can come over now, you can whack them. So the jury, hold on, cookies. So the jury finds Jennifer, her boyfriend, and the intruders all guilty and sentence them to a life in prison. So the wild card of this whole case was Jennifer's father. I mean, had he not survived that night to recount his version of the events, the ones that Jennifer was lying about, Jennifer may have gotten away with taking out her parents. The police may have suspected that it was Jennifer all along, or that it was odd, but it wasn't enough to go on until they had the dad story. And with that, I think the whole moral of the story is that love makes you do some crazy things. Stay watchful, friends.